From the Tennessee Valley Weather Channel, this is your afternoon update.
Hey folks, good afternoon. I'll tell you what, those conditions are definitely changing out there. We're in the 60s right now, still kind of in that spring-like pattern we've seen over the last couple of days, but that's not long for this world. I think this weekend's going to be a little bit less favorable for that, if I'm totally honest with you. Dew point 51, so that's definitely the moisture kind of increasing across the area. Wind out of the south, 11 miles an hour. That's bringing that moisture up into the area, so we're definitely going to see that humidity continue to increase just a little bit, but I think, especially as we head through tonight and this evening, yeah, that's when conditions really start to deteriorate. Here in southern Middle Tennessee, very similar story. Winds south-southeast of 5 to 10, temperature is 61 degrees. And frankly, if we take a look at the big picture, we can kind of see what's making this weather form as it is. We got a little bit of moisture down at the coast. We got that wind coming up here, meeting up with that warm front. That low pressure system pushing east, that's going to be our weather maker here as we head over the next several hours and into tomorrow and Sunday as well. That's what I was talking about when I said the weekend's not looking quite as favorable. Check that cold front out. 61 there in Fort Smith. Look out just behind it, Springfield, about 100 miles north at 31 degrees, 32 degrees. Yeah, it is very cold out there behind that front. But of course, we're out ahead of it for now. But we're going to see some storms come through. That's going to usher in that front over the next several hours. Doing pretty decent for this afternoon. There are those storms moving in through this evening, probably 4, 5, 6, 7 o'clock this evening. Those will push in. We'll have a good hour or two of sustained heavy rainfall in some of these storms, maybe some rumbles of thunder. Not looking for any severe weather or anything with this. Those are going to push east with time here. And by the time we're heading through about 10 or 11 o'clock, to be honest with you, I think most of us are going to be dry and behind this cold front. Right, I think most of it's going to be moving through the Huntsville Metro and point south through Morgan County, through Marshall, DeKalb County, way off to our south and east. And by midnight and into tomorrow, we actually have a pretty nice day in store for us, but it is going to be much colder and much windier. Check out those winds. North at 15, 20 miles an hour. Gusts of 25 are possible. With a morning temperature of 28 in Lawrenceburg, for example, it's going to feel brisk. As we're heading in to, say, do some errands for the weekends, bring a coat because it is going to be pretty frigid as we head over the next 24 hours. Looks like our highs are probably going to end up somewhere in the 40s, to be honest with you. Definitely a very much more February-like pattern. I think that's kind of the best way to put it. I'm kind of trying to think about the pattern we've been in, right, which is that spring-like pattern. And then I'm thinking about the pattern we will be in soon, which after this is kind of back to spring-like, right? Check out those 50s, check out those 60s, mid to upper 60s, maybe even near 70 towards the midweek here. Of course, I don't think a lot of us will see that, but you know, mid to upper 60s is pretty much a reasonable bet, right? We're seeing the spring-like pattern return, and you know, frankly, Punxsutawney Phil looks like he was kind of onto something there, because we only have a couple days of those cooler temperatures, to be quite honest with you, holding below freezing at least through Sunday night into Monday, but behind that, yeah, pretty much nothing in terms of precipitation either, at least until the middle and end portions of the week. We're talking towards Thursday, maybe towards Friday as well, as this system kind of starts to manifest, right? We're starting to see some first indications of that here about a week or so out. Of course, models will change, but in the meantime, not seeing any huge issues after tomorrow and pretty much all the way through Wednesday. And I think those spring-like conditions are definitely a nice silver lining to this forecast, right? We're going to have some more winter-like conditions over the next 24, but I'll tell you what, we get past that and we have a fantastic week, at least until about Thursday. Thanks for watching this forecast update. I'll be back with you tomorrow morning for more. Of course, today I was in for Kelly Rawson, and God bless.